but real life narrative that touched my heart and opened my eyes to a crisis bigger than all of us. You see, I stand before you not as a scientist or an expert, but a 16-year-old environmentalist, a student who's recently made a documentary about a change that is shaking up our world. It's a crisis that's not waiting for me to grow up, to become an adult, to act upon it, and I could not wait either. One of the most profound conversations I had while working on my documentary was with Mr. Munna Bhai Videsha, the salt farmer who's been harvesting salt on the very same land his ancestors have been for the past 600 years. A business, a legacy, a way of life passed on generation after generation, and yet he said to me, I won't let my kids do this business. I won't let them come in this generational work. Let's pause for a moment to let that sink in, to grasp the gravity behind these words, to understand the emotions that simmer beneath the surface. Imagine this in our context. What if our parents had said this to us? Don't do what we've been doing. Don't follow in our footsteps. Why do you think he said something so heartbreaking? I'm going to ask you all a couple of questions. Imagine a world where the alarm bells are ringing and there's an urgent warning sign. What do you think is the cause? Please raise your hands if you think it's due to an economic crisis. Thank you. Please raise your hands if you think it's due to war. Wow, quite a lot of hands. Thank you. But what if I was to tell you, while these are all warning signs, the real reason, the driving force behind this looming threat is climate change. From the technology in our smartphones to the engineering in our spacecraft, salt is omnipresent. In Kutch, Gujarat, a place where the horizon meets Salinar, the Agaryas, a community, who've been working in this field for quite a long time. A pinch of salt, simple, present every day and everywhere. But how easily do we take this simple mineral for granted? We sprinkle it on our dishes without a second thought. But behind this commonplace mineral lies a tale of global importance. Its influence extends to over 18,000 sectors worldwide. The harmony they've maintained for generations is now disrupted, and their way of life sees an uncertain future. The challenge has many sides. Erratic weather patterns now plague the salt banks. Unexpected floods dilute salt's purity, while droughts reduce the amount of water available for salt production. Hurricanes sweep in, leaving destruction in their wake. And rising sea levels harm the very land salt is produced on. To add salt to the wound, unexpected rainfall all throughout the year decreases the amount of salt produced, as the optimum temperatures of 20 degrees Celsius are reduced to 12 degrees Celsius, throwing production off balance. And the worst of them all, the 8-month operational window to produce salt is squeezing to just 5 to 6 months. And as if that wasn't enough, there is air pollution and acid rain. Both of these introduce harmful impurities into the salt, turning it black and posing health risks to the Agaryas themselves. Imagine our carbon footprint is turning even our purest salt black. So the next time you pick up a salt shaker, remember it's more than just a simple mineral. It's a testament to the spirit and tradition of the Agaryas, whose hearts, hands, and histories are intertwined into every single grain. And moreover, it's a call to action, reminding us of the intricate balance between nature, tradition, and our global community. We've all played with dominoes as children, delighting in the cascade of tiles toppling one after the other. But what if I told you that our planet, our home, is positioned in a similar state of delicate balance? Did you know that between 2030 and 2050, climate change could cause an additional 2,50,000 deaths per year? And by 2070, if no action is taken, climate change could cost the global economy $178 trillion US dollars. We must remember, when one tire falls, so does the next one, and the next one, and the next one. Every action we take, every choice we make, reverberates through this intricate web of connections. We're all spectators in this vast theater where climate change takes central stage. But we must remember, we're not just passive observers. We have the power to change the course, to realign the dominoes, to create a hopeful, sustainable, and equitable future. Looking at the sheer numbers, there are 20 billion animals, 3.04 trillion leaves globally, 1.386 kilometer cube of water, 1.386 billion kilometer cube of water. It is astonishing that we, mere 8 billion humans, could even dare to determine the fate of our planet. How can we even contemplate negotiating with nature? It is not profit or sustainability. It's about embracing both. It's about replacing the English word or with the Hindi word or. It is about profit and sustainability. It is about the three P's: people, planet, and prosperity. It is about making the right choices. Did you know, just by taking action to reach net zero, we can gain an additional $43 trillion by 2070? In 2019, the UN General Assembly president gave us a timeline. 11 years. 11 years to prevent irreversible damage. Standing here today in 2023, the countdown has become even more pressing. But amid this urgency, still lies hope. A hope for a better future. We must dare greatly. We must dare greatly to find greatness in the small everyday actions that add up. We're often told to think big, but the time has come for us now to act small in ways that lead to monumental shifts. In conclusion, our role is clear. We must become guardians of this planet. Not because it's fashionable or trending, but because it is our responsibility as evolved creatures. And if we want future generations to marvel at its beauty, to marvel at its vastness and all that this earth has to offer to us, we must become the guardians. We often ask, what kind of planet are we leaving behind for our children? But I think the more important question here is, what kind of children are we leaving behind for the planet? So let's be the change, let's be the guardian, and let's create a legacy for a more hopeful, actionable, and sustainable future. Thank you so much.